When you create a new report in Data Studio, this is the default view that you will see. While most people would just stop here or they will never explore other menu display options in the settings because this feature is kind of hidden in Data Studio. So today, I'm going to share with you multiple ways of showing a navigation menu that brings your dashboard to the next level. Also, I'll be sharing what kind of scenario is good for each type of display. How do we actually edit the navigation menu? Make sure you are on edit mode, and then you should be able to see this property panel with theme and layout. Next, you will want to click on layout. Under the view mode, navigation type, select the option that you want. Basically, there are four types of navigation look in Data Studio. The default one is called left. The second option is known as tab. It makes your report looks like a website. And then we also have a drop-down option. Lastly, we have a custom option, which is hidden, which means no navigation will be shown on the page. The navigation menu on the left is a good choice if you have more than 5 pages in a Data Studio, or when your page title is super long. The reason why I say this is because you can hide the menu to the left and it will display just the page number. Some people may find it easier to remember the page number for the navigation and just expand the menu if they are looking for other reports. The next one is definitely my favorite. For me, I really like tabs because it looks just like a website where the menu is always on the top. However, this is good to use when your page title is short. Otherwise, it will be too difficult for the user to read and navigate. So maybe I'll just show you an example. Now, you'll see, this is probably confusing if you are an user. Imagine we have 10 pages and this is just not user-friendly. Okay, the third option is a drop-down menu. So this drop-down menu, I find it difficult to use because it's very mini and it's being placed just below the title. So basically, you can click on this and choose for the report that you want, or you can click on next page from here. I guess it probably makes more sense to use this when you don't really need to navigate the report. For example, if you imagine each page represent the sales for one country, and you are just a salesperson in one of the country, then it's less likely you want to check out other pages so frequently. So this design makes more sense to that use case. Moving on, the last one is actually called hidden. So when I change this to hidden, I cannot see any button or any links for me to click on. So you might be asking, then how are we going to navigate through the pages? Well, I'm going to show you a few examples that I took from Data Studio Gallery that use this kind of hidden menu design. So, okay, we are here. This is actually created by the community, where you can see the creator creatively use text with links so that when the user click on it, it will direct it to a different pages. This is super cool because you can customize the look and feel, add a nice logo to your title. However, it always comes with a price. First, it's quite tedious to maintain this kind of menu, especially if you need to add more pages to this report frequently. Not difficult, it's just tedious for me. So you want to make sure that you only go for this option when it's really needed. Now, my question for you, which type of menu you would choose and why? If you want to learn how to set up the customized menu, please also leave your comment below so that I know what to do in the next video.